Hi there! Today we're going to talk about Lecce in Italy. The city of Lecce is located in southern Italy and is the main city of the Salentine Peninsula, the landmass which forms the heel of the country when viewed on a map. It is one of the most important cities in the region of Apulia and is the capital of the province, which is also called Lecce. It is a location that is steeped in culture and history and is known among many visitors and locals as the Florence of the South. This nickname is mostly due to the opulent Baroque monuments and buildings from the 1600s that can be found throughout the city, as well as its traditional affinity with classical Greek culture and art. As for the origins of this city, the legend goes that it began its existence during the time of the Trojan War and was founded by the people known as the Messapi, who are believed to actually be Cretans. These people called their city Sybar up until the 3rd century BC when the Romans conquered it and its name was changed to Lupia. The name was retained for a number of years but was later changed once more to Lycia or Lytium in the 2nd century AD when the ruler at the time, Emperor Hadrian, decided to move the city 2 miles to the northeast. That wasn't the end of it though, as over the centuries, Lecce would experience many more changes in rulers and governments as it got invaded by various groups such as the Saracens, the Lombards, and the Slavs. However, Lecce began to truly flourish in the 11th century after it was conquered by the Normans. It became a major commercial city and later on was also considered as one of the most important fiefs of the Kingdom of Sicily back before Italy was united. This is a distinction that continued throughout the medieval ages and the Renaissance. Despite the many conquerors that have passed through their lands, however, Lecce's Greek roots remain strong. In fact, to this day, there is a group of towns near the city that is collectively known as Grecia Salentina, where people still speak a dialect known as Greco. This speech is a hybrid language that is a cross between Greek and the traditional Apulian dialect. These days, Lecce remains as busy as ever and enjoys much tourist traffic thanks to its comparison to Florence. It is also known for one of its many imports, the Pietra Leccese or Lecce stone, which is a malleable type of limestone that is a favorite material among many sculptors and builders. It is also an agricultural center, and its main products include olive oil and wine, in particular, reds like the Primitivo, the Negro Amaro, and the many colors of the Salice Salentino. As for the local attractions, we did mention earlier that Lecce is famous for its beautiful Baroque architecture as well as its Greek and Roman roots. So here are some of the spots you can't afford to miss while you're in this city. Your first stop should be the Chiesa di Santa Croce or the Church of the Holy Cross. The construction of this church actually began in 1353, but it was only completed a few centuries later in 1695. One of the most unique characteristics of this church is that its facade features motifs that were unusual for its time, such as fantastic beasts and plants, grotesque figures, and vegetables. This was a deviation from the more religious themes which was prevalent during that period. Meanwhile, inside can be found 17 altars as well as the tombs of the members of the Adorni family, as well as that of St. Francis of Paola, the founder of the Roman Catholic Order of Minims. Next, there's the Church of San Niccolo and Cataldo, which is considered as one of the finest examples of Norman architecture. It was founded by the famous Tancred of Sicily in the 11th century, but has undergone numerous renovations over the years. Its facade, however, is from the original medieval structure. Here, one can also find numerous frescoes from the 15th to 17th centuries. Meanwhile, there's the Church of the Theatines, also known as the Church of St. Irene, which is a structure that was built in 1591. It is of particular interest to religious visitors because of the numerous relics of saints that are housed here. Though the interior itself may seem rather modest, it is more than made up for by the ornate altars that are decorated in the Rococo style. Next up would be the Colonna di Sant'Oronzo, or the Column of St. Orontius. It is a tall column located in the main piazza and it is crowned by a statue of Lecce's patron saint. The column was originally erected in the town of Brindisi, north of Lecce, and was used to mark the end of the Via Appia, the ancient Roman road that connected Rome to the south. In the 1600s, however, the citizens of Brindisi sent it to Lecce in gratitude as they believed that it was a miracle by St. Orontius that stopped the plague that was ravaging the region at the time. There is also the Arco de Triunfo or Triumphal Arch, which is more commonly known as the Porta Napoli and is one of the main gates of the city. It was built in 1548 to welcome the ruler of the Holy Roman Empire and King of Italy and Germany at the time, Charles V. Nowadays, it marks the point of entry into Lecce's historical center. These are just some of the numerous points of interest in the beautiful southern city of Lecce. If you ever drop by, make sure to also pay a visit to the 2nd century Roman amphitheater and the local archaeological museums, Sigismondo, Castromediano, and Fagiano. Lecce is a city with a rich past that's just waiting to be discovered. So take your time and take a leisurely stroll through this jewel of the south.